Welcome to the stream. Gonna pop one of these open. We're back at it again with some Ocarina of Time. Oh, yeah, Link. So, remember last time when I was bitching about using the Pro Controller? Remembered that I had the Switch. The Switch GameCube controller, so it's a Switch controller that is modeled after the GameCube. There are some things different about it. One has an extra Z button, which is actually on this controller says L and R, because that's how it is on the Pro controller. But on the original GameCube, this is a Z.
Right.
So it has two of these, and then it has like the Switch specific controls. But everything else is the same. You know, the C stick. Cool. And all that. So, because the main thing about the Pro Controller was the C-sticks fucking me up. So now, while this is not an N64 controller where it's literal buttons, it's made in a way where it's like...
Yeah, I can see the cutout.
Yeah, because of the ridges and everything, it's a lot more accurate too.
Right.
Than just using a full-ass analog stick. And it just feels better to use a GameCube controller for this, because like I also used to play Ocarina of Time on the GameCube when I had the collection.
Mm-hmm.
Now this is not as good as the GameCube controller in plenty of ways, because like these are slightly different shaped, and the GameCube controller, these were analog, meaning it was pressure sensitive.
Okay.
Opposed to it being just triggers, where it's just like, it's just one hit and you're done.
Right.
Hey, Dez.
Hey.
Welcome to the stream. And I tried using a normal GameCube controller, but the mapping was wrong. I couldn't Z target because this was turn on and off the map.
Okay.
It did that instead.
Right.
And you can't remap the buttons for the GameCube controller. Like, there's no programming for that.
Right.
So, I couldn't do it. You have to have Z-Target. Anyway, last time, we did get all three Spiritual Stones. And now... Look. You collected three Spiritual Stones. But look, it's closed even though it's daytime. Now the clouds are getting shitty.
Oh, no.
All right, here we go.
It goes good.
Cutscene.
How about yourself?
Yeah.
It's,
been busy.
We did a lot of grilling. Well, Skylar did a lot of grilling.
Yes, that was on Sunday.
So it's been a lot of leftovers the last few days, which is great.
Yeah. Can you put the screen back?
Oh.
You left it completely open.
It's not completely
open. Yeah, it's basically completely open. Put it over the backpack.
Oh.
So it kind of...
Oh,
like,
so it was... Yeah. I gotcha. Okay. We good now?
Yes.
Okay. But yeah, so we did the grilling outs for Father's Day.
Yeah, a lot of house stuff.
Lot of house stuff lately.
And then... Just our normal stuff. Working, streaming.
D&D.
That's going good.
Oh, no.
Man, cutscenes like this in 1998.
Uh-huh.
It's like epic as shit. I lost her. You, over there, little kid.
Hi.
You must have seen the white horse gallop past us now. Which way did it go? Answer me.
What horse?
So, you think you can protect them from me? You've got guts, kid.
Darn tootin'.
Pull out a sword. Heh. 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 Whoopsies. You want a piece of me? Very funny. I like your attitude.
Thanks.
Oh no.
And we're dead?
Yep, just straight up dead. End of the game.
No, I don't actually. Who are you?
Pathetic little fool, do you realize who you're dealing with? I am Ganondorf. And soon I will rule the world. Ganondorf. And he goes off. Also, Death says, I'm silently suffering by myself like a real man up here where I'm at.
Aww.
Jesus Christ.
Sad face.
Suffering's not good.
Right.
Don't do that. You just more of the truck work getting stuck somewhere shit.
Well, hopefully you're not stuck somewhere again.
Anyway, you saw Zelda throw something.
Yep.
You go in the lake. You grab the thing that you throw. It's the Ocarina of Time.
Oh.
It's what the game is named after.
Roll credits.
Link, can you hear me? It's me, Zelda. Ellipses. Link, when you hold a Ocarina in your hand, I won't be around anymore. I wanted to wait for you, but I couldn't delay any longer. Yeah, she put like a soul in there or something. At least I could leave you the Ocarina and this melody. It's a song of time. It's like my go-to when they pull the Ocarina out. Oh. I didn't want to press that one. What?
Hi. Why are you yelling?
Come here.
You're gonna suspend. Mario RPG fans are eating good this past few years. We got Mario plus Rabbids, Super Mario RPG, Paper Mario, Thousand Year Door, and now the upcoming Mario and Luigi Brothership. Yeah, the Mario RPG, like, we got the remake and Thousand Year Door this year, and then we're getting Brothership, which is another RPG. Yeah, which is fucking insane how the retrospective works. Even without me spinning the wheel this last game. I just, I'm stopping with the wheel. I'm just going to go with, one, whatever was on the list that I wanted to play, and then just whatever retro games I wanted to do. Mm-hmm. But I started playing the Mario Luigi Superstar Saga, and then this Nintendo Direct, they fucking announced a new Mario and Luigi game in that series.
You always do that.
I don't know how that keeps happening with the retrospective specifically.
Yeah.
Like, it's insane how the timing just is perfect. It's insane. Anyway. You've learned the Song of Time.
Well,
I have nothing to give you, Kat.
Well, come on.
I'll bet you. I don't know what you want from me.
Silly kitty. Well,
she'll figure it out. Now, Link, play this melody in front of the altar in the Temple of Time. You must protect the Triforce. Protect it.
All right. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Do backflips. So yeah, our fairy Ocarina gets replaced with the Ocarina of Time. So, sorry, Saria, but we got a better gift from the princess.
Damn.
Get wrecked. We're in the market. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. All right. I can't give you anything, Kat. I'll have anything for you.
Come here. This way.
She's gonna keep meowing at you instead. Okay.
There you go. Like, stop bitching. No. I stop slicking my teeth. It's gonna annoy me.
Nope. I don't know what she wants.
Well, I'm toothpicking myself. Hang on, let me check it.
Oh, my.
Oh, I totally did not see Dez's last message. Did I not tell you I took off to North Dakota to work? You said you were going to be away for a while. You didn't say specifically where, you could be away for a while because of work. What?
So, North Dakota. Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to pretend I know where states are.
Well, like, when you're looking at the map, it's over here somewhere. You know, like, we're...
Oh, yeah, that's perfect.
You know, like, we're
over
here
somewhere.
Yeah, you know, like, we're here, and that's over here somewhere. I know what I'm saying. It's fine.
What? All right. It's all time. Now, the cool thing about, like, the development of this game, while we get the door of time open, is the composer for this game was given the challenge, because of the mechanic of the ocarina, was given the challenge to make however many songs is in this game with only using 5 notes.
Right.
Because you got the 4 C sticks, up, left, right, and down, and then A as another note. So making all these songs with only 5 notes.
Right.
And all of them being different enough from one to the other. Not small feat. Also, let's go through this cutscene before I talk about memes. Link, isn't that... Why would Link know anything? He's just a forest boy. It's that legendary blade.
The sword in the stone.
The master sword. The sword.
Master sword.
So, remember the old meme? I think it was based off of Pit My Ride. Where it's like, I heard you like this, so we did this.
Uh-huh.
And they just like, repeated the same.
Insane, yeah.
So, one of my favorite memes is like, I heard you like time, so you have to go to, what the fuck, I gotta get a train in my head. You have to go to the Temple of Time and use the Ocarina of Time to open the Door to Time to pull the Master Sword out of the Pedestal of Time. It's pretty good.
So this moment is a meme.
But this moment, back in 98, fucking epic.
Right.
Look at this shit.
Doesn't he being mind blown?
Yeah. Excellent work.
Thanks, bro.
As I thought, you held the keys to the Door of Time. You have led me to the gates of the sacred realm. This was his plan all along. Yes, I owe it to you. I owe it all to you, kid.
Wow, great.
Link. Wake up, Link, the chosen one. Okay, now we're going to get a lot of exposition. So okay. It's going to be one of those scenes. Where the fuck?
Hello, big man.
I am Ra'u, one of the ancient sages. Ages ago, we ancient sages built the Temple of Time to protect the entrance to the sacred realm. This is the Chamber of Sages, inside the Temple of Light. The Temple of Light, situated in the very center of the sacred realm, is the last stronghold against Ganondorf's evil forces. The Master Sword, the evil-destroying sword that you pulled out of the Pedestal of Time, was the final key to the sacred realm. Link, don't be alarmed. Look at yourself. Oh, shit.
Whoa.
I'm big. Look, Link. You're big now. You've all grown up.
That growth spurt hit fast.
Yeah, fast. Not like it's been 7 years or anything.
No, I was fast.
The Master Sword is a sacred blade which evil ones may never touch. Only one worthy of the title of Hero Time can pull it from the Pedestal of Time. A lot of time. However, you were too young to be the Hero of Time. Therefore, your spirit was sealed here for 7 years.
There we go.
Yeah, see? 7 years. And now that you're old enough, the time has come for you to awaken as the Hero of Time. Well, do you understand your destiny?
Sure.
No! Again, the illusion of choice.
Right.
But remember, though you've opened the door of time in the name of peace, you fucked everything up. Ganondorf, the Gerudo King of Thieves, used it to enter this forbidden sacred realm.
Well.
He obtained the Triforce from the Temple of Light, and with its power, he became the King of Evil. So, yeah. So, great. Because in order to try to save Hyrule or whatever, Link goes through and pulls the Master Sword. That Ganondorf uses that opportunity to get into the Sacred Realm and touch, like, to access the Triforce.
Right.
But I think they're going to explain what I was about to say here, so we'll finish the scene.
Okay.
His evil power radiated from the temples of Hyrule, and in 7 short years, it transformed Hyrule into a world of monsters.
Yikes.
My power now has only little influence, even in this sacred realm. Namely, this Chamber of Sages. But there is still hope. The power of the sages remains. When the power of all the sages is awakened, the sages' seals will contain all the evil power in the void of the realm. I, Ra'u, am one of the sages, and your power to fight together with the sages make you the Hero of Time.
Yay!
The Hero of Time, chosen by the Master Sword. Keep my spirits with you and find the power of the other sages and their might to... Wait. And their might to your own. There we go. Sometimes words are hard. And we got a light medallion. We get the first medallion. Now, it is... I don't know how true it is. If developers talked about it or not, but there was supposed to be one more temple, and like a temple of light, and you would have gotten this medallion from that said temple, but I think due to time constraints and stuff, they had to scrap it.
Okay.
But we received the light medallion because we're here. So we have to get all the medallions. Find the other sages and save Hyrule.
Right.
Bitch. But yeah, so because of the unevenness of... Because, you know, somebody of, you know, let me do this. So the Triforce, it, you know, the power of the Triforce grants the wish of whoever touches it. And if they are pure evil, it will bring out the evil wishes. If they're pure good, it'll bring out the good wishes. But
right.
But the Triforce is all about balance. Power, wisdom, courage. But because Ganondorf is very unbalanced, instead of it completely giving him the his wishes, the Triforce split into three parts. Which means Ganondorf got the Triforce of Power, because that's what he craved the most.
Right.
And the other two parts, the Triforce of Wisdom went to Zelda, and the Triforce of Courage went to Link, because that is their biggest attributes as
right.
characters.
Okay.
And I think that they talk about it more later, but I think that was a good time for me to tell you. Link, we're back in the Temple of Time, but have 7 years really passed? It looks like you won't be able to use some of the weapons you found as a kid anymore. Let's get out of here. Let's get the fuck out. I've been waiting for you, Hero of Time.
Here I am.
It's me. When evil rules all, an awakening voice from the sacred realm will call those destined to be sages who dwell in the five temples. We've got Sheik's theme here. One in the deep forest, one on a high mountain, one under a vast lake, one within the house of the dead.
Okay.
One inside a goddess of the sand. Together with the Hero of Time, the Awakened Ones will bind the evil and return the light of peace to the world. This is a legend of the temples passed down by my people, the Sheikah. So yeah, this is the series introduction. This is a series introduction to a lot of things, just in general, that were mainstays for the rest of the Zelda series.
Uh-huh.
And this is our first scene into the Sheikah. I am Sheik, survivor of the Sheikahs. As I see you standing there holding the mythical Master Sword, you really do look like the legendary Hero of Time.
Sheik is in Smash 2, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's where I've heard the name before then.
Yep, Sheik is in Smash.
Sorry. Anyways.
If you believe the legend, you have no choice. You must look for the five temples and awaken the five sages. One sage is waiting for the time of awakening in the forest temple. The sage is a girl, I'm sure you know. Because of the evil power in the temple, she cannot hear the awakening call from the sacred realm. Unfortunately, equipped as you currently are, you cannot even enter the temple.
Great.
But if you believe what I am saying, you should head to Kakariko Village. Do you understand, Link?
Yep.
I guess.
Oh, I didn't ask you that time.
Yay, we're adult, Link. We're gonna go.
Yay.
Wee. So, also, now that we are grown up, the Hylian shield that was just on our back that we couldn't actually use...
There it is.
...is now on our arm, being able to use like a normal shield.
Tap, tap, tap. Cool.
Tap, 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 tap. Okay. I'll say, for some reason, they moved. You go there. I like my ocarina to be on the bottom. I don't know why. It's always just... It's always been a thing with me. The ocarina always goes on the bottom C. Also, so you said, you know, Sheik being Smash. Do you remember anything else from Smash regarding Sheik or no?
Yeah, don't you... Can't you, like, flip between the two?
Two of who?
Of Link and Sheik.
No, not
right?
Link.
So Zelda, then.
Okay, so that.
I do remember being able to.
Yes, so Smash. You knowing Smash kind of ruins the twist of the game.
Oh.
That's not a bad thing. I'm just saying that because of your history with Smash, like I'm gonna explain the twist now that Sheik is Zelda.
Okay.
So Sheik is Zelda, and you realize of that because you played at least Brawl, and that was a mechanic. 4 and Ultimate, they make them separate characters.
Mm-hmm.
But in Melee and Brawl, Sheik and Zelda, you do down B, and you switch between the two.
Right.
But that was like especially back in the day, or anybody who just plays this now who's never really touched Smash, that was, like, a big twist. I'm like, holy shit, Sheik was Zelda this whole time. So, we get that twist, like, near the end of the game. But you've played Smash, so you already...
Yeah.
Yeah. It's hard to keep things like that. Look at Death Mountain. In the distance. It has a volcano ring. Also. So, now we know that because of the 7 years, Ganondorf has fucked shit up. And whatnot. So if we go into the market, it's fucked up and dead.
Oh no.
And there's zombies. They're called Redeads. But they're zombies.
Is that Redead?
Yes.
Okay.
Not undead. Redeads.
Got it.
And if we go to the where Hyrule Castle used to be.
Oh my god, it's like being in DMC.
It's Ganondorf's castle now. Yeah, so he essentially now in the future timeline, he's won. Like,
right. Everything's all fucked up and sad.
Because yeah, he got into the Secret Realm because we pulled the Master Sword, this thing right here.
Right.
And everything's fucked up.
So really...
Now, like, Hyrule Castle and Hyrule Town is the most fucked up, but everything is a little off.
Right. So really, though, this is all our fault.
Yeah. But
we're not really being a hero, we're just unfucking...
So, like, it was like it had to be done in order to, like, still defeat him, but also this also creates... This game, again, one of the games that makes it the most important game in the series, is this game is what caused the timeline split. If you ever heard Legend of Zelda talk about, you know, how the timeline works and there's a split, this game is the reason why there's a split. Because of Link's actions here, having the child Link and the adult Link, everybody believed that there was only two splits, the child timeline and the adult timeline. Nintendo officially released the timeline in the book, which at the end, like near, at the end of the game during the credits, I will actually go over timeline shit with you. Like, I will open the book. But for now, there was also a downfall timeline that was introduced. So there's actually three splits.
If he
succeeds as an adult, there's this timeline where shit's still like recovering. But then there's the child timeline. Where when he goes back to being a child, after the events, but then there's also a downfall timeline. When this Link in this timeline fails, there's a separate timeline for that. Which essentially what Nintendo did was just shut all the old games that were made before this into that timeline, and then any games that were made after that was like a sequel to one of the old games. But really, all the old games that were made before this, like all the 2D games, are in like the downfall timeline.
Right.
Over there.
Okay.
So that was like kind of their solution to that.
I like it.
But yeah. And look. The bridge. Oh. Fucked. But we go, like what Sheik said, we go over to Kakariko. In order to get the item that we need to get to the Forest Temple. It's nighttime. Doesn't really matter.
Get our steps in.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
All right. Alright, so what we need is actually in the graveyard. If we go to the graveyard. And we go over here to this flower patch. I believe it's this flower patch. And we go to this hole.
Oh.
Question mark.
Ooh.
Alright. So, it's Dompe. So, we didn't really interact with Dompe a lot, but the gravedigger, not the gravedigger, the groundskeeper, when we go here at night, the old guy, not the kid that's there, which you didn't even see the kid during the day, but the old guy that's here, that's him. He's dead now.
Oh, okay. Cool. He looks kind of dead.
Yeah, I mean, are you fast on your feet? I may not look like it, but I'm confident in my speed. Let's have a race. Follow me if you dare. So yeah, we have to follow him. He throws fire at us, and we have to try to keep up with him.
Interesting.
Yeah.
He seems pretty easy, though, so that's good.
It's because I know what I'm doing.
Yeah,
but he does throw fire at you. So you have to, watch out for that.
Right.
If you're not too conscious about it, you're going to just get blasted with fire. So many things in... Also, there's, so many things that you're seeing in these games. Mm-hmm. Whenever we get to the Zelda campaign, and even some of this stuff I'm going to be doing in the Pirate campaign even.
Right.
I'm going to be translating these challenges to D&D stuff.
Right. Oh, so I'll have a one-up on everybody and feel smart for once. Well, because everybody else, as soon as you're describing something, they're like, oh, it's this item, or oh, it's this monster.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, what?
Yeah. So that's going to be the fun thing once I start writing the Zelda game, is that none of you fuckers, you're going to have a one-up on everybody now that we're going through Zelda, but the rest of them aren't going to really know much.
Well, that's
they know what they've came across on the internet, that's about it.
Just like that, puzzle that we did. I was like, oh, this is the...
Yeah, the Lost Woods thing that we did? Yeah.
And you were like, yeah, because that's exactly what it
is. I literally recreated that map. I took a map, an overhead map of it, and then I recreated it.
Yeah.
Legit. And then I just added, a little D&D flair to it. One more thing, be careful on your way back.
Be careful, but, I just threw fire at you the whole way here.
Yeah, that's fine.
It's fine.
We got the hookshot!
Oh!
Yay.
What does it do?
It's a hookshot.
It's grappling hook?
Yeah.
Okay. While holding C, you can do things with C.
So, yeah. So, I'm going to set it instead of my bombs. And, oh, no. There's a blue block. What do I do with a blue block? We play this all the time. And it vanishes. Bye-bye, blue block.
Yay. Dude, we're so grown up now.
So grown up. Look at us. Do 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 do. Song of Storms.
Are you even gonna make or not make it, but use the sound as background sound?
What do you mean?
During your game?
When we go through the actual Zelda campaign, not the Pirate campaign.
Right.
Instead of using my original songs, I will
You're gonna do this
I will be pulling up Zelda music that fits to the scenario.
Amazing.
100%.
I love it.
Look how pissed off he is. Let's pull out Ocarina.
If I had that on my head, I'd be pretty pissed.
You've got an Ocarina. What the heck? That reminds me of that time 7 years ago.
Yep.
Back when that mean kid came here and played a strange song, it messed up with this windmill. And
okay.
So, since we're here, we're gonna learn the song, even though we don't actually need it until four temples from now. Yep, Song of Storms. Ben. So again, we're not gonna need it for four other temples from now. The fine.
He could look like second. He's doing something very inappropriate.
Yeah, he's a hump in the music box. So, funny thing. So, you learn the Song of Storms as...
See? What the fuck is that guy doing?
He is...
That's what I'm saying.
He's really enjoying the Jack in the Box. Look how fast that's moving.
He's jacking in the box.
He's all man.
ankle.
Wait, yeah.
Oh my god. Gross.
Anyway, so
anyway.
So crazy thing about time. Time's a fickle thing. So we learned this song from him because he got pissed off because when as Kid Link you could go in here and in order to get into the well, which we were not gonna need for another again, four temples. We have to play the song of the Song of Storms in this windmill in order to access the well.
Right.
But we only learned the song as Adult Link because he heard it from our kid self.
That's crazy.
And then our kid self is the one who showed him the song, but then in turn our adult selves ones who learn it. Time. Time travel.
Yep. Good thing it's so easy.
Anyway, we got Hookshot, we got a Song of Time, which again, we don't need a Song of Time. Song of Storms. We don't need a Song of Storms until later. But we have a Hookshot. And I can't do my... So now, also as an Adult Link, if I save and quit and then go back, we restart at the Temple of Time instead of the Kakariko Village.
Okay.
Also, I should just save just in case. Because saving is always good.
Yes.
And that's how quick it is to save in this game. Literally, if you just press B at the start menu... Would you like to save? Yes. Alright, sick. Bye. So fucking easy.
Legit.
So fucking easy to save in this game. And because it's cartridge, it was cartridge based, it was like that. When when the game went like for the collection for the GameCube, saving, it would do the same thing. You press start, press B, hit save. But
then it would think about it.
Yes, it would like go to a black screen and be like saving. Do not turn off the console.
Right.
Saved. And then I'll go back into the game. But since this is emulating N64, which means it's emulating a cartridge, bam, save. 2 seconds. Maybe not even. Anyway, we're told to go to the forest. So we're going to the forest. Yay.
Yay.
Itch. So itchy. Shut the fuck up. And we're back in the Kakariko Village. Oh no!
Oh.
A giant Deku Baba. Yeah, so every area we go to, Ganondorf has fucked it up in one way or another.
Right.
So, yeah, there's monsters and shit in Kakariko Village now. So all the, that Kakariko in the Kokiri Forest. And all the Kokiri are, like, if you want to talk to any of them, they're all hiding in their houses. But, I don't know why I'm going this way, because I don't need to be going this way. We go over here. We gotta go through the Lost Woods.
The Lost Woods.
Yeah. I have an itch on my leg. I did it.
Are you just skipping that thing?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You don't have to care really hardly anything if you don't want to. And then we go through the rigmarole.
So how goes it, Trustin? How you doing?
Yeah, how do it be doing?
How do it be doing?
And here's this prick. So during randomizers, if you don't have what you need here, there's a very specific back jump, backflip you can do to actually bypass him, because he just kind of, like, doesn't let you go.
Right.
But you could backflip over him. I've done it on randomizers. But the real way to do it is,
I'll play you a little song.
So wait, if you talk to him, he's like, I'm not going to let you go, because I don't know you. Fuck off. But that melody.
The song of my people.
Saria plays that song all the time. Do you know Saria? That song. Saria taught that song only to her friends. Okay, I trust you. When I see you, I don't know why, but I remember him.
Well.
Yeah, because we're grown up, so they don't think... It's like, because... I don't know how many of the kids knew that he was a Hylian. Outside of, right. like, maybe Saria. So, him being, like, an adult now, and Kokiri's being permanently kids forever.
Right, kind of messes
so
with
So, they're
them.
Like, you look familiar, but you can't be him.
Right.
Like, that's, like, the whole thing there. I okay, how are you? He asks. So, he do being okay.
He do be on the okay. I also be on the okay.
Yeah, we're just, you know, doing house stuff, doing stream stuff, work stuff.
Stuff.
All the fun stuff. Oh my god, you're teaching me how to look around corners.
Well, not everybody's played this game 100 times.
But she's already taught you how to look around corners. It was in Dodongo's Cavern. She's like, look around the fucking corners. Use the Z to do the thing. Now she's doing it again so
use
we can...
Use the Z to do the
now,
thing.
Now she's doing it again so we can fight these moblins. By the way, these are moblins. They're fucking huge in this game for some reason. For some reason, their front is, like, very guarded. But you can one-shot them with hook shots.
Okay. Why didn't you do that?
Did you not see me hitting him? And it was just... like, his front, like, there's, like... Like, his spear has, like, such a large hitbox.
Okay. Ow. That hurt one of my hearts.
Alright, I'm just gonna wait for him to turn around.
Goodbye! There we go. Shoot him right in the ass.
Right in the ass. And now he's dead. Oh, I'm going this way. I'm supposed to be this way. Also, now that you're adult Link, the camera doesn't go above like when you were a kid Link.
Uh-huh.
Because of... They changed the enemies here. Go this way. And there's an asshole right there. Yeah, wait for him.
Yeah, big boy. Tick tock.
Yeah, just kind of, just kind of patrolling.
I don't know how you don't us with the head sticking out of the water, but
yeah, I'm glad your field of vision is directly in front of you. Nothing
above
more.
Or below.
That's bullshit. Okay, turn around again. Thank you. So I guess I was too close. Sick. Yeah.
Tased him in the butt.
And now we're here. And now there's a big one. Look at this fucker.
Oh my god.
And then, yeah, he fucking shockwaves.
But we don't care. We'll just walk right up there and do the thing.
I was trying to crouch stab him to make it, like, quicker, but it didn't work. And I murdered, and he drops 20 rupees.
Yay!
Even though I'm maxed out on rupees.
Boo.
And now we're gonna get a cutscene.
It's like you're a professional or something.
Where she used to sit. Oh, fuck.
Saw, dude.
It's a sheik. The flow of time is always cruel. Its speed seems different for each person, but no one can change it. A thing that doesn't change with time is a memory of younger days. In order to come back here again, play the Minuet of Forest. So, one of the,
But that's a harp.
And? What does that matter?
We don't have a harp, we have an ocarina.
Yeah, funny enough, notes aren't the same.
No.
That's kind of how music works.
No.
So one of the things is, if you put all the things that Sheik says together, it does become like one full like poem type thing.
Uh-huh.
And one of the things when we were going through things that to put on our... for text to read.
Oh, uh-huh.
You know, for the wedding. I don't know if you remember, but one of the things was the poem, the full poem that Sheik recites, like, throughout the five times you meet Sheik. Because Sheik gives you the songs, they're teleportation songs. But if you put it all together, it's like one full poem.
Right. I don't remember that, but...
Yeah. Yeah, so that was, yeah. So now you're seeing, like, in context, like, all the stuff that he says. So we chose the Kingdom Hearts one because that one was better. So now we have a hookshot. Now we can get up here.
Sweet.
So going back to past areas, but being able to access new areas within the past areas.
Yeah, that's awesome. Oh.
Yeah.
You guys are big.
Get fucking ambushed. All right, so before we even enter the full temple.
Mm-hmm.
We have to get up here.
Do a little climby climb. Oh, that's way up there.
Yeah.
Some more climbing.
There's a golden scotula. Don't need it. We're not collecting them.
Why not?
Because we're not.
Oh, they don't give.
They just give the tokens, and the tokens give you items if you go to the scotula house, right, but they don't give them anything that is required for completion. Like for story completion.
Right. Okay.
So now the dungeon's in Adult Link time. Small key. You need keys in order to access a lot of the doors. So that key, if like your first time playing, is very missable, which is probably why the 3DS remake of the game actually does like a camera zoom out.
Oh, to be like, hey, this.
Yeah, it's like, hey, like it disguises it like, hey, this is the Forest Temple. Here's a cutscene to show it off.
Right.
But it shows that there is a chest up there, instead of just like here where it's just. We're here now. Also, fun thing. So I redid my computer again. Oh yeah, what'd you do to it?
Yeah, what'd you do?
So I remember these guys where they drop down. The only way to hit them is their backside. So they do.
Yeah.
If you use a hookshot, it just goes right through them. They're fucking dead. Hookshot one kills them.
Nice. Okay. So that thing's legit.
Yeah. So not only does it bring you places, it kills things too. It's pretty sick. And so it'll kill enemies like that, smaller enemies, and it will stun bigger enemies. Well, I was asking for the Windows 10 USB, right? Yes. Were you trying to reinstall Windows 10 because they automatically update your computer to Windows 11? I didn't get that update. My computer wasn't forced to be. Granted, my computer thinks I don't have my Windows activated, even though I signed in. And I've been using the same Windows for fucking, like, over a decade. And I've had the same activation code the entire time. And it was connected to my account. I signed to my account. They're like, you're not activated. I'm like, well, go fuck yourself. I'm not rebuying it. Go away. Anyway, yes, you were asking for the Windows 10 USB. Which, I don't have. Go away. Go away.
I don't remember there being a 9.
There wasn't.
Oh, okay. What was it called?
They skipped it.
Oh.
It was Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 8.1, and then Windows 10. Because the reason for that is because, you know, how back in the day there was Windows 95 and Windows 98?
Yeah.
They didn't go with Windows 9 because that... There was a potential to fuck up software that could have been confused, thinking that being optimized for Windows 9 could also mean trying to be optimized for Windows 98, just based off name alone. So they skipped 9 and went straight to 10.
So I remember 98, XP, Vista, and that's it.
And then 7, yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, we're fighting a... Stalfos. I almost said Scarchulas. They're not Scarchulas. They're Stalfos. See? Stun them.
Right.
Hit them.
Legit.
Hit me, bitch. My laptop was blue screening a few times after the redo after Windows 11. Blue screen's not good.
That's not good.
Give me a fairy. So I wanted to bring it back to factory OG thing, so I found a hidden partition on the HD from way back when all the OG files were from factory. Oh, so you had to restore it. The system restore.
Boo.
So I did magic and was able to install the OG factory installs. I mean, GG, being able to fix it. It sucks that you have to go through that.
Right.
But because I remember needing to fucking do factory resets all the time because of my PC breaking all the time. It was stressful times, dude. System restore didn't work, so you had to do a factory restore. Damn.
Yeah, that sucks.
That's a bunch of wiener. It's just so much like, it's just more snappy.
Snappy.
Like. Because it's not gonna, okay. So feel this. Just like feel how like how it feels.
Right. Feel how it feels.
Uh-huh. And then feel the right stick on the Switch. Totally different.
Right.
A lot less snappy, because it's fully analog, opposed to this being... It's still analog, but it's just made differently.
Right.
So, it's so you can be a lot more accurate with this C-stick.
Yeah.
Which is good.
That's another thing that's really impressive with you, is your ability to just switch constantly in and out with the different controllers.
Yeah.
Because... I don't know, that's just too much for me to remember. Like, I'm pretty sure I've talked about this before.
Man, it's all about positioning.
But the biggest thing for me was I did PS1, PS2, and then flipped to Xbox, and then PS4. So that whole time that I did 360, having the X in a different place, just like really, it just really messed
with me. Yeah, I mean, like, I have really, like, trained my brain to kind of, like, deal with that. But also, like, a lot of games, like, even though, like, buttons are named differently, positioning for certain actions are always in the same spots. So, like, if you play an action game, light attack tends to be where the square is, or on the Xbox, where the X is. Mm-hmm. And then heavy attack tends to be triangle or Y, or shit like that. So, not only, like, remembering, like, what buttons do what, like what the names are, but also just positioning helps. Like, so even if you're not like thinking about like what letter it is, just knowing what position it is, like,
true,
helps. Oh,
made it.
But also I grew up with both Nintendo and PlayStation simultaneously, like the entire time.
Right.
So, being, and especially with the N64 being my first controller, and then also going to PlayStation, then GameCube, and then...
Well...
So, like, PlayStation was always the same, but then going from N64 to GameCube to the Wii to...
Right, Nintendo just switches their shit up every time, so...
Yeah, because they innovate. They don't stay stagnant.
The 64 is the weirdest freaking controller ever, though.
Yeah, but I got used to it. I mean, it was my first controller, so it's fine. But yeah, so being able, so having just two different consoles in the house like that, like, I think just trained my brain.
My first,
plus I just play a lot of games, but
my first Nintendo controller was just a little rectangle with two buttons.
Which was oddly innovative for the time. All everything Nintendo does is innovative. And then everybody else follows. Outside of like current, like, recently, like, power of the consoles, but like when it comes to like actual like hardware, Nintendo is like second to none. Like when the Wii was popular, everybody was like having like the Move, you know, the PlayStation Move and shit. Or yeah. Like what, like even with Super Nintendo, they tried doing like the Power Glove, so like motion control. Mm-hmm. Are you using a cam, like, IR sensors, but they were using a camera? But right. I'm pretty sure that kind of technology is what inspired PlayStation to do the iToy, which then in turn inspired Xbox to do the Kinect. I used the ladder to catch myself. So like,
yeah, I remember,
and shit like that. Or like now, like the Switch came out, and now, like PC companies, like you got the Steam Deck now, which is like a handheld console that is shaped like the Switch.
Well, yeah, but there was a PSP.
Well, yeah, but that, so like hybrid consoles that are like in the shape, like that size, shaped, and like the Steam Deck, I don't know if you can play on TV or not, but like that idea of like the hybrid console, like the Switch is both, like I'm playing this on TV right now, but I could literally pull it and we could just be playing it right here.
Right, right.
And so that idea of like that type of console, also, yeah, the PSP was a thing, but Game Boy was, you know, fucking, yeah, like the 90s.
Right.
It's like, and before that, fucking Game & Watch, which was a Nintendo product.
Right. Yeah, speaking of Smash, fuck that guy on there.
Goddamn.
Savage. I don't, he was always just really hard.
he does have a decent moveset, especially in Ultimate. Go away.
Well, yeah, all right, so clearly, we got, you know, the only two Smash games I ever played, so.
We can play more Ultimate. We have some fun with Ultimate. What? Alright, so I've gathered three keys. I haven't really used them. Now I've used one of them.
Ah!
Die. And you drop hearts, don't need it. Actually, if you don't have hearts, it drops rupees, which I also don't need. I don't need any of your shit.
Damn. We're just so professional here.
Hey, climb.
All work, no play.
Because I'm awesome. Alright, so we're here. No.
Listen.
These are arrows point. Thank you. I didn't fucking see that there's arrows on the goddamn floor.
I didn't.
Well, yeah, because you're bad at looking at things.
Yeah.
Alright, so we have to go over here. Over here. Over here. Push the block.
Pushy, pushy.
Alright, that was one too far. Now we're here. Now, we go over here. We're gonna pull it just a little bit. There's probably a more optimized way for me to do this, but.
Yeah, what?
Push over here.
Why do you have to do it step by step?
Because it has to go to a very specific direction.
Okay.
So now it reaches the wall. Because you can't pull a block all the way where it needs to be if you're trying to pull it, because Link is in the way. So I have to push it.
Okay.
In order to get it all the way where it needs to be.
Right.
Because you can only pull so far. Like, it's one space away because there's a Link in the way. And these hallways are made exactly the size of the block.
Right. Interesting.
And now we drop it, so then we can climb. Because it's just a little too high to climb until it drops in that little circle.
Right.
Well, square. Circle goes in the square.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Now this bitch. We're just gonna pull it because we're up here. But see how, like, I can't pull any farther because the Link is in the way.
Right.
So now we have to go back down.
Oh my god.
What?
So how many trial and errors was this? Or
it like a lot of puzzles really is just looking around, connecting the dots, and be like, okay, what am I missing? Where do I go? And clearly, obviously the game gets harder the more you get into it.
Whereas me the other night, freaking just in and out of the mirror, trying to move around the stone bridge to get through the first trial.
Oh.
For Hogwarts Legacy.
Yeah. So, maybe the reason why I'm so good at puzzles in video games is because I grew up on this shit.
Right. Started them young.
Yeah. I always point at Zelda being one of the many good games for development because it really does work your brain. Not only with all, the actual, dialogue,
But puzzles, reaction.
Yeah, well, time, yeah, like yeah, the combat with the reaction time, and then like the puzzles, like, really challenging your brain, and stuff.
So fuck preschool. Make our kids play Ocarina of Time.
Yeah, Zelda games are good for development, or any game that has puzzles. But this is very like this is fun puzzles. It's very interactive.
Yeah.
Watch for the shadow of the monsters from the ceiling.
What?
Oh, so yeah, we just went through a twisty room, if you didn't notice that.
Yeah.
There's a pose on the wall, we can't fight them yet. Because you get close, they just vanish, and you can't really do anything about that. So we go in this room. And there's another Staphos. Ow.
Ow. Were you down one heart already, or did he really do two?
Nah, I'm pretty sure I was down one heart.
Okay. Gonna say like shit.
But now here's the kicker.
CPU temp is sitting around 180.
180?
Is that good or bad?
That's in Fahrenheit. What's it? For some reason, when it comes to CPU temp, I know Celsius better, like where it should be. Just because that's usually
what kind
what's
of American
in.
Are you?
CPU temp is like the only thing that's like that for me. Because it's always in Celsius for some reason.
But you can't apply it to like real life situations?
I don't know conversion rates.
Oh, okay. So like only specific numbers.
80 Celsius, okay. Well, because I know like a PC, like the temp range for a CPU for a PC.
So is 80 good or bad?
80's fine.
Oh, okay. Well, good then.
You don't start running into problems until you get to, like, 110. Like, 110 is when you start running into problems, which is hot as hell, but that's why you start running into problems.
So, yeah, with my laptop, like, overheating my thighs when I was, like, 12 was really bad.
Oh, yeah, because, yeah, if the CPU overheats, then, yeah, you're gonna run into issues. That's why, like, my computer kept on crashing, because mine wasn't getting regulated correctly.
Yeah, with that laptop, like, it would get so hot that it would just shut off.
Yeah, that's why.
Yeah.
That's why that happens. Alright, so, yeah, the problem with that fight was that, you have to kill both of the Staphos quick enough.
Mm-hmm.
Because then if one of them dies, and then you keep on fighting the other one... you don't kill it fast enough, the other one revives. So, I had to kill it, and I wasn't really doing a good job. So, anyway, we're going to open this. And it's going to be a bow. Fairy bow.
Da-na-na-na.
So now. I'm gonna set it. It comes with 30 arrows. Fucking sick. We're gonna go back to the OG room that we were in. I think this was the OG room. If not, then we're gonna have to backtrack a little bit more. But, now that we have a bow and arrow, they can't. I'm gonna just strike them.
Sweet.
And now that you don't have any more paintings to go to, now I can do that. So, I don't know if you noticed at the beginning of the temple, but there were, like, there was an elevator in the middle, and then there was four flames.
Uh-huh.
The flames got put out, and then because the posts come out of them. Now, the kind of the theme of this dungeon is trying to find the pose. Because, these ghost things are called pose.
Okay. Like Edgar Allan?
Yes. Exactly. Alright, come at me. Alright, that's one poke on. Better percent of the other.
Yeah.
Slurp.
Slurp.
We got another small key. And more arrows. So now we did that. Now we can go back to this room. So then we can go to the other room. Also, another fun fact. The forest temple So the medallion and like the image of this temple is this. So during development, the Forest Temple was actually originally, they were originally making, so I'm pretty sure Forest Temple was also like planned for like future, but they were originally making a Wind Temple. Now they never, so the Wind Temple never got made, but certain things from the Wind Temple got transferred over to the Forest Temple. So the image of the Forest Temple actually kind of looks like wind.
A wind swirl.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So like that's like a carryover from development. Crazy enough. Now this Poe is just like the other Poe we just fought. And they're right next to each other. So but this one's blue. And now you have no more paintings to go to, so now I hit you. There goes to the bottom of the thing.
Cause he's blue.
Yes. Come on. Yeah, take that. Bite me. Are you drinking a beer?
Yes.
100%.
Root beer.
She is drinking the root of beer.
Yes. The very root.
So technically.
Chicago style.
It is specifically Chicago style. It means it's cool or whatever.
Nutrition facts. 180.
Why?
Beer.
180 beer.
Calories.
It's a big chest. Well, we already got the main item. We already got a dungeon map, so it's gonna be a compass. That's the thing. Every dungeon has three big chests. One of them, well, technically four now that we're adult Link. One of them is a dungeon map. One of them is the dungeon's item, and then the next one is the compass. That's everything. Everything else is gonna be small chests.
Why are you drinking beer?
Oh, well, I'm.
Are you drinking beer?
Always. That's like his favorite. You literally told me about this the last time there was a room with Wall Masters. Why would you tell me again?
You're right.
What?
He is drinking beer.
Yes, that's his favorite pastime. He watches streams and drinks the beer. That's his relax time. Just like good old white American. I don't have a key for this. I am missing a key. Why am I missing a key? Oh, I know why I'm missing
Speaking
a key.
Speaking of being a white American, I don't know if I asked you this before. Do you want to do a 23andMe?
Not necessarily.
Because I do. I'm just like... Because obviously I kind of know what I am.
I know mostly what I am, and I'm fine with that. I definitely know what half of me is, because my mom is 100% Serbian, so like that's kind of right. A no-brainer there. I am a Euromutt.
Euromutt?
Yeah, it's just all the Europeans thingies. Nationalities. Alright, so now that we have a bow and arrow, we're going through this twisty hallway. Meow. Twisty, and it's a hallway.
My brain.
We go back into this room. There's an eye above this. We hit it.
Oh.
The twisty becomes untwisty. Which means the room that we were just in is now different because it is now we're on a different wall of it.
Okay.
And you see this was attached to the wall earlier, but now it's on the floor, where we can get to it.
Yay!
So now, if you ever see this design of the chest, it's 100% the boss key. So now there are boss keys within dungeons now.
It's pretty.
Italian, Irish, German, Polish, and then some.
Nice.
Polish sausage or
whatever. So, did you put it in the order of, like, what you are the most like percentage-wise? Of? Because I am mostly Italian, also. I am those first three. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's all I know for sure, is those first three. Like, I don't think I'm Polish.
Yeah, I'm on my mom's side, like, I'm 50% Serbian because she's 100%. Like, there's no question on that one. And then my dad's side, I'm mostly Scottish. And then and then there's, like, everything else, like, kind of thrown in there. Because my dad's side was mostly Scottish, but then his mom's side was, like, Euro-mutt, basically.
But don't you want to find out if you're, like, 3% Indian or whatever?
No.
I do.
I think my dad said we are, like, a percentage.
See?
But I don't... It doesn't change anything. I don't actually give a shit. I only care about what I mostly am, and I'm happy with that heritage that I mostly,
I don't know, it's like, still cool
delve into. Like, all the other shit doesn't matter to me. I'm not connected to any of that. So it doesn't matter to me.
It's still cool, though.
Nah. Key. Door. Other door. But this one swings. Alright, now we're back here. We got the small key that I needed, which means I have to travel back to where we were.
Oh my god.
Untwist the room that we untwisted, so we're actually twisting it again.
Oh my god.
But I have to fucking get up there first.
And you're supposed to...
The game, like... So you're not, like, actively doing it, so, like... And I'm just kind of fucking blasting through it, so you're like, holy shit. But, like, it is all about, like, how puzzles and temples work, where, like, you exhaust all your options, and you just try to figure out, where have I not been yet? And then using the new tools that you got, you can access more of the temple. Because, like, there's only so many places you can go without the tools that you're needed. Once you get the tools, it opens up more spots, and then... You just kind of you hit your head against the wall until you find a soft spot in the wall, you know?
Right.
And then
create a soft spot in your brain.
Molly, that happens too.
Tristan said, "Hey, listen." I'm sure that helps a lot.
Navi does give hints every now and then. That's how I found all my holes. All of them.
Oh my god.
Alright.
I thought you were doing like Pink Panther there for a minute.
Nope. I missed the jump. So I need to climb. Make sure the wall master doesn't get me.
Sweet.
Don't need to fight them. They're...
Okay, bye.
Haha.
Nice.
Now we're in a rotating room. So now... There's a switch. But it's an ice. What do we do about that? Well, there is one single torch in this room.
Can we fire through the... That's what we do, yeah.
Yeah, you nailed it. So yeah, the room gives you the information, and then you connect the dots with said information. So now, with that, the room that was straight is now twisted.
Ah, twisty!
Which means now we can access more. Which means we access this hole.
Yay, holes! Now we're playing chess.
I need to double check where this door goes. Okay, it leads back to the main room. Okay, don't need that. But yeah, so, not necessarily chess, but that.
Okay.
No shit, I fucking saw it fall. God damn it, Navi.
little behind, Navi.
Nope, that's not good. Okay, I need to hit the switch. Switch has been hit. Opens the door. That closes. I need to watch out for Scotulas in the sky. I need to grab this because it's a key. I'm pretty sure. Oh, no, it's arrows. Okay, I don't give a shit. I'm gonna die. I was not quick enough. All right, let's try that again. I don't know if there's a timer on the Switch or it's just open now. God damn it. Nailed it.
Nailed it.
Through the door. And then I'm gonna hit these two because I need health. Only one of them held health. Now, this Poe.
Oh, sorry, Cap.
We gotta put the blocks together. And a time limit.
Cool.
But one of the blocks are useless. It's this one.
Yeah.
Now, it is a different order every time. But it's
the same.
Yeah. They're usually kind of where they need to be. You just kind of have to push it together.
Why do the spiders stand on the front two legs?
Because they're weird.
Good answer.
Yeah, the sky ones, I think it's supposed to represent like them beyond like webs. Like why they drop like that. There's just no like model for the web.
Right.
So they just look like they're flying or whatever.
Alright. My back hurts.
Well, stop that. Alright, come on, come on, come on, come on.
The way he laughs kinda sounds like Boo.
Yeah, I can see that. Nintendo, especially back in the day, did reuse a lot of assets between games. Like, this game is running off the same engine, even, that Mario 64 was.
Okay.
So, it's definitely possible. Because reusing assets instead of making new ones. Like, a very well-known secret in Mario 64 is that the Bowser laugh is just the Boo laugh slowed down, or vice versa.
Okay.
It's the same exact laugh, so same exact soundbite, but one's just, it's just slowed down.
Right.
To be, like, so the higher pitch one's just a sped up version of the laugh, which is the Boo laugh,
mm-hmm.
and the slowed down one is the Bowser laugh.
Nice.
Now we're in the main room.
I had something else I was going to say there, and now I forgot. That happens to me all the time.
Yeah? Now, it's a purple Poe.
Oh. I mean, so Disney and Pixar do that a lot, too. Where Pixar, not so much, but where they use, like, the same thing over and over again. So, like, if you watch a lot of old Disney cartoon movies, you can catch like a lot of the same like movement types, just with the characters looking
right. Obviously, yeah, they use
slightly different.
Yeah, they use the same animations.
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
Which because it wasn't computer animation, so it's not like wireframes. But yeah, they use the same animations, just kind of draw.
Yeah, like, I watched a
different
video
character in that animation.
I watched a video on it, and
it saves resource time.
Right, and it, like, showed all the different... Like, the one I watched was, like, of characters dancing, like, in a circle, like,
yeah.
Hopping around in a circle, and how they just, like, applied that to, you know, multiple...
Yeah, because it's good for timing and resource management.
And then I can't remember what the other movie was, but in...
Also, this Poe's different. There's four of them, and then you have to see
and
which one's...
And they're scary looking.
Yeah, a little bit. And then, but you just gotta pay attention. The one that spins is the real one.
Oh, shit.
And you just gotta fucking... Gotta arrow them. Just like that. Anyway, what were you gonna say? I just wanna talk about the mechanic here.
I'd have to look it up, because I don't remember what the other movie is, but Pixar used, like in the movie Coco, when they show you like the whole village of all the spiritual beings. I forget what they're called right now. But when you see like the whole town like all lit up and stuff, they use that exact same layover for another, they don't even use it as a town, but for another like network type.
Oh yeah.
Thing.
Yeah. Again, so just saving resources and time. It's a lot of developer secrets in that, and video games especially, because video games take so much as well. So there's a lot of reusing of assets and shit. Anyway. Like, I mean, most of Majora's Mask is just reuse of assets because he only had a limited amount of time to make that game. And so, Majora's Mask being the direct sequel to this, he just reuses so many assets.
Well, that's like...
And that's why, like, a lot of characters are, like, characters from Ocarina of Time, but they're, like... But it's played off as, like, it's an alternate, like, version of Hyrule, Termina.
Right.
Which, you know, fun fact, Termina, based off the word terminal, because the moon's gonna fucking crash.
Nice.
Because I was, you know, I don't know if you watched the retrospective stream of it, but... Or how much of it you pay attention to, but yeah, the whole thing is, you know, Majora being connected to Skull Kid, making the moon crash onto Termina.
Right.
And making, you know, everybody's gonna die. Or whatever. Like an airport terminal. Yes. Actually, just like the airport. Makes me want to go terminal.
Oh my god. Well, that's... So I was gonna say, that's just like, we were playing Sonic. And some of the levels, you were like, this is exactly... such and such.
The cyberspace levels were... Like, a lot of the... Most of the level designs from the cyberspace levels were based off of... Not even based, basically just copied from older Sonic games. Yeah. So, Sonic Frontiers had, like, all those... Well, levels.
Like, that was so funny when... Because it's one thing to, like, recognize it, and another one to, like, fully remember it. So you're doing stuff, and you're like, yeah, and here we're gonna, like, spin, and then you climb up this thing. And then it would happen, like, right after you said it.
Yeah, like, yeah, these rails are gonna lead me to this thing, and... Yeah. Especially the Sonic Adventure 2 levels, because I played, like, as a kid, played the shit out of Sonic Adventure 2.
Right.
So, going through those levels... Yes, terminal, not anal. We're not...
What?
I don't think Zelda's into anal. Pretty sure. But,
I don't know. Can't tell what his type strikes me as.
Well, Zelda's a she.
Well, I'm staring at Link, so that's just where my brain was, but...
Well, I said Zelda.
I know.
Fake fan. What the fuck was I gonna say? Oh, yeah, the Sonic levels. Yeah, so the Sonic Adventure 2 levels, yeah, like, when I realized it, like, I was playing one of them, like, oh, this is, like, this is the exact layout of whatever.
Yeah.
And I was freaking the fuck out. Huh. Aww. There's pictures. I guess there's nothing in this room. Oh, shit. Did I play that? Did I act that well?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, she might be. It's Ganondorf! Why are you here?
More like Ganondork.
Oh, shit. You're so original. But no, he took off his face. It's Phantom Ganon.
Yeah, that's pretty terrifying.
So, also, talking about developer secrets, this boss fight is also, like, shown to be seen as a leftover from development. This game was originally going to be almost like Mario 64 in the way of, like, going through areas through paintings.
Right.
But using Ganon's castle as the hub instead of, you know, like Peach's castle. So using Ganon's castle as the hub going through paintings to go to other like sections of the world.
Yeah.
I'm glad they didn't go that route because that would have been cheap to me. But this is kind of like left over of that idea where Phantom Ganon goes to the painting and you have to, you know.
Yeah.
The whole going through the painting part. The mechanic of this fight is that you got to see which one he comes out of and then strike him. But sometimes he'll fake you out.
Ah!
So you got to...
Damn.
You got to guess which one's going to be the real one and see if you could actually...
Like, be ready.
Yeah.
So this fight could potentially take a really long time.
Yeah. And this is just phase one.
Oh.
Nice. I fucking missed.
Oh.
Yeah, I almost got to him, but I was like a little off to the right. It's hard to be accurate while being that fast.
Yeah.
Oh, this one makes it easy. Which one is it going to be? That one. All right.
Got him.
Here's part two. Dead Man's Volley. Okay, he didn't really volley that one. Depending on how you do this one, you can actually do this one actually pretty easy.
Right.
In some cases, this one's actually harder than, like, the one in, like, the final battle. Spoiler alert, he uses this tactic in the final battle.
Okay.
But depending on how you do it, you can make him not volley at all if you... Because this one, like, physics-wise, this one reacts differently than the one in when you fight actual Ganon. So you can actually kind of fuck with it.
Okay. So the other one is, like, straight back?
Yeah,
I'm assuming.
Yes. Yeah, you actually nailed that pretty hard. But this one, it actually kind of bases off like, how you hit it.
Right, it's perfect.
So what I like to do to avoid the actual volley part, because, like, once he hits it back, it actually gets pretty hard, is I go to the right and I sideswipe it, and then if it hits him, like, it's outside of the hitbox where he, like, wants to, like, retort. I did not want to spin attack there, and that fucked me up. That's fine.
Well, that kind of looked like Badman. You take it. No, you take it. Or like ping pong.
Well, yeah, that's why it's called Dead Man's Volley. You volley.
Right.
But if you lose, you die. Or whatever.
Yeah, like that guy. Look at him.
We're about to get dialogue.
Wispy.
Hey, kid, you did quite well. It looks like you may be gaining some slight skill. Just slight. But you have to defeat only my phantom. When you fight the real me, it won't be so easy.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what you think. What a worthless creation that ghost was. I will banish it to the gap between dimensions. Yeah, Gandor's all like powerful and shit now.
He's so dramatic.
No, you. Hey, you can take this back. I don't want it. Ba-da-da-da, more health.
Yay!
And I'm gonna backflip into this because I'm cool.
I was about to say, except it didn't work, but it just took a minute.
And also, we could teleport through a crystal. It's different. Because we go to the Chamber of Sages.
Secrets.
It's Aria.
Yeah.
Thank you. Because of you, I could awaken as a sage. She's the sage of the forest.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Oh my god.
So Sheik was foreshadowing. I am sorry, the sage of the forest temple. I always believed that you would come because I know you. No. You don't have to explain it to me.
Yeah, I'm
all a fucking powerful sage and shit. Because it is destiny that you and I can't live in the same world.
Aww.
I will stay here as a forest sage and help you. Now please, take this medallion. Ba-na-na-na. So, also, every time we see sages in Legend of Zelda, they tend to be different sages.
Okay.
The sages... that are in this game are, like, what I like to think as the main ones. So whenever we get to the Zelda D&D, so when it comes back around to me, again, it's going to take fucking forever. These, like, when it comes to, like, deities in the world, the sages are going to be part of, like, the deities. And these are the versions of the sages I'm going to use. This is Ocarina of Time's version. Sorry, we'll always be your friend.
Aw.
Yeah. So much lore. Hey, look. A dead guy. Well.
Well. Let's pluck it.
You say that.
Oh. Now it's a Pokemon.
Yeah. Look at him. Hi there, I'm the Deku Tree Sprout. Because you and Saria broke the curse on the forest temple, I can grow and flourish.
Yay!
Thanks a lot. Yeah, because Ganondorf, you know, cursing things and shit.
Right.
Hey, have you seen your old friends? None of them recognize you with your grown-up body, did they? That's because the Kokiri never grow up. Even after 7 years, they're still kids. You must be wondering why only you have grown up. Well, as you might have already guessed, you are not a Kokiri. You are actually a Hylian. What a twist. I'm happy to finally reveal the secret to you. Yay! Lore.
Lore.
Some time ago, before the King of Hyrule unified this country, there was a fierce war in our world. One day, to escape from the fires of the war, a Hylian mother and her baby boy entered this forbidden forest.
I wonder who it was.
Maido. The mother was gravely injured. Her only choice was to entrust the child to the Deku Tree and the guardian spirit of the forest.
The Lorax.
Yes. The Deku Tree could sense that this was a child of destiny whose fate would affect the entire world, so he took him into the forest.
Man, no pressure.
Yeah, right? After the mother passed away, the baby was raised as a Kokiri, and now, finally, the day of destiny has come.
Yeah.
Ah. So, yeah. Again, like, people say, like, games that are rated E for everybody is, like, kid games, but, like, this game talks, like, literally a civil war in Hyrule and a mother, like, dying and trusting her kid to a forest deity.
Yeah, dude.
Shit's dark.
Right.
And now you have learned your own destiny.
I mean, all, you know, hero stories have to start out a little dark. That's just
The
rule.
That's just, so. Yeah. That's why you go on adventuring or whatever. So you know what you must do. That's right. You must save the land of Hyrule. So go do it. Now, Link, break the curse on all the temples and return peace to Hyrule. Cool. Alright, bye. So, yeah. So, he replaces this guy.
Yeah. He's so cute.
Yeah, the little sprout. Which, yeah, also lore-wise, so even though he is, like, it's his own thing, he's, like, now the new deity of the forest, he does retain the memories of him.
Okay.
So that's why, like, even though he was literally just born, he could fucking speak full English or whatever.
Yeah.
Or Hylian, I guess, technically. But without the, like, old speech, because he's a fucking hip new tree now. Not like those old trees. He's hip with the kids.
Hip with the kids.
Alright, so now, things don't kill you anymore here.
Yay!
So, now the Kokiri are just...
So pretty looking.
They're just out. I still think you really look like somebody I've seen before, mister. This is my rock now. Haha!
Okay.
This is mine. It's not mine anymore.
I was about to say, so do you come out with the...
No, it does not go through loads. So now,
So now you save, because it's been a little bit.
I mean, I could do that.
Giving you a reminder.
Okay. Now there's a couple things I could do. So let's go get a horse. It gets a while on the ranch before it becomes night. I am veering off course.
Yep.
Ah, I didn't want to pick up the plant. Fuck you.
What did that plant do to you?
He got picked up by accident. Fuck him. I'm just looking at the map.
Yeah.
To see where I am. Tree! Nope, I don't want to fuck with you, Poe. Go away. Lon Lon Ranch. But now... it's ran by, Malin's,
Look at that face, dude.
Yeah, so this is... so, his... he's the lankier brother of the one guy. The sleepy guy. The,
okay.
Yeah, Malin's dad.
Yeah.
So, the comparison is, that he's, like, supposed to be, like, Luigi. Look at the green shoes.
Yeah.
And before he became, like, this, like, this rich asshole, because, so, Gandorf gave him the ranch, basically. Because this guy's a dick. He does wear, like, blue overalls with, like, a green shirt, just like Luigi. Anyway, yeah. Let's talk to him. There are some people in Kakariko spread rumors that I cheated Talon out of the ranch, but don't be ridiculous. That guy Talon was weak. I, the hardworking Ingo, poured so much energy into this place. I don't want any strangers like you saying anything bad about me. You're a dick.
Yeah.
Listen, the great Gandorf recognized my obvious talents and gave the ranch to me. I will raise a fine horse and win recognition from the great Gandorf. Say, young man, do you want to ride one of my fine horses? Pay me 10 rupees. And you can ride. Yeah. No, I know how to ride. It's fine. So, he kind of gives you a horse. But, if you play...
a secret.
If you play the opponent song, the opponent comes to you.
Yay! Look at him.
Yeah, look at her. Nope, I wanted you to move, not get off. I don't have time to dick around. Alright. And now we have Epona.
Now Carrots is the pony's health.
It's the stamina. And now also, Epona is the only one who can actually jump over this fence. If you try to grab the horse that he gives you, she doesn't jump over that.
Sweet. Okay, thanks, dude.
When you want to dismount, stop and press A. Hey, young man, do I know you? It just felt, though, as I've seen you somewhere before.
Nope.
If you use Z-targeting, you can talk to me from horseback. Are you ready to go home so soon?
Yep.
I always forget, like, how to... okay, I guess I'm gonna ride some more. Until the time's out. Because I know I'm trying to get opponent out of here, essentially. That's what I'm trying to do. So. That guy looks sus. Because he is sus.
Right? Like that fucked up face.
Yeah, he's a little fucked up.
A little fucked up.
Pay me 10 rupees. Yeah, okay. I'll do it again. No. I collected 10 rupees because I jumped over the fences. So I'm gonna...
and why are we doing this the second time?
Because I'm trying to make it so he... there's things I have to do to make it so he... challenges me to a race. For the horse.
A duel.
Yeah, so you have to do this twice.
Okay.
Yeah, you're getting better. How about a little race? One lap around the corral with that horse. Let's make it a little wager. Say 50 rupees. Do it. All right. So we have to race him.
I don't like his eyebrows and mustache. Yeah, the eyebrow, like, with the one being, like, shooting out, is so weird.
A little bit. So, yeah, if you stay on the inside, and especially if you push your way through that little first segment, you're almost guaranteed to win.
Okay. So it's like most racing games, yeah. Just stay on the inside.
Stay on the inside. A lot of racing games, like, depending on the track, you have to be really good with how to maneuver it, but yeah. But especially that first push through is, like, very important for that race. Shoot! If the great Ganondorf found out about this humiliation... Hey, you, how about another race? If you win, you can keep the horse.
Well, yep.
Come on, go, 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 go.
Damn. Ah, okay. We're good.
But I just gotta make sure that I don't run out. Because if you use all the carrots, then Impona, like,
slows down. Right.
So you gotta use them in the sparing manner. You can use all of them all the way up to one. So, but if you use that last one, she slows down a lot.
Right.
So, yeah, he gets better at that second race, though. Time it out. What's up with that horse? Is that Epona? How come you tamed that wild horse right on my nose?
Well.
I was going to present that horse to the great Ganondorf, but I bet on a race and lost. Shoot. As I promised, I'll give you the horse to you. However, I'll never let you leave this ranch.
That's cakes. Okay,
how could you?
Jump right over it.
Yeah.
Whee! Bye.
Yay. You fucking thought. We got a horse.
Yay.
Fucking epic. Look, let's go. So now we have a horse. So now
Purdy horse.
Yeah. We got the legendary horse, Epona. So now, with our horse, we could kind of traverse this a little bit faster. And yeah, you use Epona song, she will always show up. And then later on, to get to a spot, you need her to jump. It's like the only part where you're like required, and technically you're not even required to use her to get over, but but now we're gonna go over to Death Mountain.
Oh yeah, just real casual.
Yeah, you know, because we did the forest stuff, now we gotta do the fire stuff. Actually, we need to go back to the Temple of Time. Gotta go back to the Temple of Time.
Yeah, but did I just see you hit reset?
Yep. So it's like reset the cartridge. So now I'm here. Remember when I told you that this is where he starts the game when you start up, boot up the game?
Oh, right, right.
Because I need to talk to Sheik. Because she blocks your path to the... until you beat the Forest Temple, she blocks your path to the pedestal. Because you could go back and forth between child and adult link. You destroyed their wicked creatures that haunted the temple and awakened the sage, but there are still other sages who need your help. In order to awaken all the other sages, you must become even more powerful. You must travel over mountains, underwater, and even through time. If you want to return to your original time, return the Master Sword to the pedestal of time. By doing this, you will travel back in time 7 years. 7 whole years. Time will come when you will have to return here quickly. I will teach I will teach this to you for when that time comes. The song to return you to the Temple of Time is the Prelude of Light.
Here we go.
Ba-do-do-do. Upright. Upright, left, up. See, it's so much more accurate. B-do, snow blorb.
So well, now, so much too.
Yes. So now, we can teleport to the forest temple, and now we can teleport to the Temple of Time.
Yay!
We did it. You hold time itself in your hands, Link. We shall meet again. Kapoof. Yeah, we're gonna see each other real soon. Alright, so now we could teleport back here whenever we want.
Sweet.
But now we gotta go. Now we go back to Death Mountain. Actually, I'm gonna try and make things quick. We're gonna teleport. What the fuck? There we go. I was doing it wrong. So there's actually, we need to go to the Goron City first.
Okay.
There, from the Lost Woods, there is a path to Goron City. So I don't have to go through fucking Hyrule Field and then Kakariko Village and up Death Mountain. If I go this way. Okay, bye.
Waste doing my time. All the cheats.
Couldn't hit me because I was on a ladder. Now we jump over the maze. Bye-bye. Go back through the forest. I could run this backwards, or I could just make sure I go through the wrong entrance, so then I could just kind of reset. Now if I go over here, and straight into this area. And I switch over to the 8 bombs I have.
Yeah, kaboom.
We're here.
Oh my god.
We're in the Goron City. We did it.
Yay.
Doo-doo. I don't need rupees.
Well, then quit collecting them. Silly Billy.
I'll stab you. I'm gonna go all like. Anyway, see this guy?
Yep.
Just kind of rolling around?
Yep.
We have to blow him up.
Oh!
Yeah, he'll be fine. But the timing, because he keeps rolling, so the timing is hard. Come on, come on, roll back into it. Blow up quicker, ass face! Damn it, fucking bomb. Alright, alright. So the second I see him, I'm gonna pick up the bomb. Bomb! There we go.
Sweet.
How could you do this to me? You're Ganondorf's servant. Hear my name and tremble. I am Link, the hero of the Gorons. Who the fuck do you think you are? That's not your name. Bitch. Alright, talk to me.
What?
Your name is also Link? Then you must be the legendary Dodongo Buster, the hero Link. My dad is Darunya. Do you remember him?
Nope.
Man, you're bad at memories.
Yep.
This is why I always try to have to like re-explain things. Yeah, Darunya is the big Goron guy that we made dance with Sirius on, and then eventually he gave us the Goron Ruby.
Okay.
The king of the the king of the Gorons.
Right.
Dad named me Link after you because you're so brave.
Aww.
It's a cool name. I really like it. Link, you're the hero to us Gorons. I'm so glad to meet you. Please, give me your autograph. Sign it to my friend, Link of the Gorons. Oh? I guess it's not a good time to ask you for this. Please help everyone. My dad, Darunia, went to the fire temple. A dragon is inside. If we don't hurry up, even my dad will be eaten by the dragon. Boo! Yeah, he starts crying.
Aww.
You better try to calm him down if you can. Maybe he will calm down if you talk to him. What do you want to ask him about? The dragon. A long time ago, there was an evil dragon named Vivalgia, living in the mountains. That dragon was very scary. He ate Gorons.
Yeah.
Using a huge hammer, the hero of the Gorons. Boom!
Yeah.
Destroyed it, just like that. This is a myth from a long ago. But it's true. I know because my dad is a descendant of the hero. And then more crying. Alright, then we talk about the Gorons. Everyone was taken to the fire temple. While my dad was out, Gandorf's followers came and took them all away.
Tristan said, who?
That guy. Yeah, Vivalgia. Vovo. Why is he twitching? Because he's sad or whatever.
Yeah, he's like sobbing.
Yeah, like a bitch.
Wow. Rude. My beer's almost gone.
He's whacking. Always the whacking. Dad said that Gandorf has revived Vivalgia. As a warning to those who might oppose him, Gandorf is going to feed them all to Vivalgia. Dad went to the fire temple by himself to try to save everyone. Please help, Link. I'll give you this heat-resistant tunic.
Ooh.
Buy that boot derp. So yes, this
That's not green.
Yeah. Yes, yeah, you're right. It's not green.
Yeah.
I'm glad you learned you're not colorblind.
But we're Link. We are green.
But it's
just what we do. We be green.
No, we're red now.
No.
See? We're red. Look at us. We're red.
Weird.
We're heat resistant now. So now we could go into Death Mountain without burning alive. This game's so perverted. All characters just flogging the bishop. I think you just want them to do it.
I mean,
I have a feeling you're projecting.
I guess Tristan and I have the same kind of brain then, because that's what I'm thinking.
You heathens.
Yep. Dirty dogs.
What? You should give him a bath.
Well.
Oh. Indeed. I mean, I know Tristan wants to...
Indeed.
Yeah, polish the pole or whatever. And if he's Polish, that'd be a Polish pole polishing. The floors have to be a mess. Oh my god. I don't know if rock people could really do that. I don't know.
Well, how do they make more rock people?
Honestly, I'm pretty sure, like, Gorons are asexual, and they... I don't remember the exact lore of how, like, birth is given, but they are not mammal-like creatures. They are asexual. And asexual not in, like, well, we don't like sex. Asexual as in they don't have gender.
Look at that. How do Gorons reproduce, have babies, reproduce Reddit?
See, she gets it.
Like, they don't have any females in the race, and I don't see them laying eggs. I don't even have reproductive organs. Okay, so what's the answer? In what game are they afraid of magma?
What? They never are.
Yeah. Alright. Reddit, you're letting me down. They make a rock snowman and it turns into a baby. They reproduce by budding. Those rocks that grow on their backs eventually grow and fall off.
Yeah, so, like, okay. Almost like a fish. Certain fish. Not most fish, but certain like a sponge.
Right.
like a sea sponge. Like they parts of them pop out and then it gets nurtured into a new Goron.
Right.
But yeah, so they are asexual creatures. Now, it's hard to tell with N64 graphics, but yeah, all, like that texture on the back is it's all right. Rock.
Right.
Hey, what's up?
You're a big dude.
My brother opened a new store. It's Mini Goron's Blade Store. However, I am better at making blades.
Better.
Hylian Carpenters praise me for my skills. I'm not lying.
Lying. Brother.
Yeah. Anyway.
Hey, brother.
So now we can actually go to this part. So if you're wearing anything that's not the Goron tunic, when you're in Death Mountain Crater, they give you a time limit. The time limit is actually based off of your health. So the more hurt you are, the less time you have. But there is a time limit for you to be in here, or you will then get, like, hurt and
okay.
Stuff. So, but now with the Goron tunic, I'm fine.
Right.
Oh, I just realized I need to get here a different way.
Oh, no.
All right, I have to go back to Goron City.
Burb.
But we already okay. Have to restart. Well, have fun with that. Fine. I can take break my legs. It's fine. Watch for the shadows. Watch for the shadows. Shadow the Hedgehog.
What?
You heard me.
Wrong series. We've done that already.
Yeah, you're right.
So casual. The fuck?
Yeah, because I know what I'm doing. I know where I'm landing.
I definitely don't.
Rock.
Hey!
Yeah. Alright. So actually, I have to go back down here. Go through this.
Bomb powers.
And then.
And then.
We pull this guy out. Bad day, British nerd. So this is where Darunia once stood. And also danced.
Right.
So we go this way. So now we are. Can we fucking hit the fucking. Are you serious? So now. We're, like, that's where I couldn't jump because the rock was in the way. So going through Goron City brings us here. And. Bridge is broken, but we have a hookshot.
Hey!
Now we're here. And sweet. Sheik! There it is. Hi, Sheik.
Sup, dude. That's how Sheik talks.
Yes. Sup, dude.
Dude.
It is something that grows over time, a true friendship, a feeling in the heart that becomes even stronger over time. The passion of friendship will soon blossom into the righteous power, and through it, you will know which way to go. The song is dedicated to the power of the heart. Listen to the Bolero of Fire.
Oh. Bolero.
Yeah, Bolero. Do 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 do. Boo doo boo doo boo doo boo doo. So when I cast Fireball, this is what I will play when I'm a bard.
Okay.
Yes. all the songs I'm gonna be playing as a bard through the Ocarina whenever I get to that character. And yeah, it's gonna be shit like this.
but you are gonna have to say Fireball.
Yes. I am gonna say
or like do the thing and then Fireball.
And I say like, yeah, I cast Fireball. Boo doo ba da boo da. You learned the Bolero of Fire. Bolero. Bolero.
Bolero.
Link, I'll see you again. Ah, fire.
Man, he's got a big pointy nose.
Yeah. N64.
I like big noses.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The ones that could poke your eye out.
Well.
This rock's mine. Hey, 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 rock. Hey, hey, hey. Oh, I did not know that. The animation of Link hurting makes the rock disappear. That's funny. And now we are in the Fire Temple. You try to go to the right, the door is closed.
Oh no.
I kill a fire keys. So we go through the only door that is left. Because this is the game telling you, hey, go this way. So then we can talk to him.
Hey.
It's Darunia.
Yeah.
Who's there? Is that you, Link? Oh, it's really Link. You've grown so big since I last saw you. I want to have a man-to-man talk with you, but now is not the time. Ganondorf is causing trouble on Death Mountain again. He has revived the evil ancient dragon Vivagia. On top of that, he is going to feed my people to that evil dragon as a warning to the other races that might resist him.
Okay, but who eats rock?
Gorons.
Well, yeah, but...
And a legendary evil deity dragon. Because he is also... Vivagia is also, like, a deity as well, but more of an evil kind. If that fire-breathing dragon escapes from the mountain, all of Hyrule will become a burning wasteland. I will go on ahead and try to seal up the evil dragon. I'm concerned, though, because I don't have the legendary hammer, but I have no choice. Link, I'm asking you to do this as my sworn brother. While I'm trying to deal with the dragon, please save my people. The prisoner cells are in the opposite direction. I'm counting on you, Link. Well, not all the prisoner cells are in the opposite direction. One of them's in here. So, this dungeon temple,
yeah,
is all about saving Gorons. You could talk to them and they will give the same couple tips and then they run off. But that's a waste of time. You could just stand there. I don't care. Because they give you keys when you save them, so.
Right.
And you can talk to them, and then they'll, like, run off, but I, again,
don't
give a fuck.
Don't give a fuck.
So now we are on our way to the rest of the dungeon. Let's go this way first.
I did not know you could walk on that, and I almost
had almost a moment. Out. Door.
Ooh, look at he fucks up an attachment.
Good for him. Here's another Goron. We already saved another one.
Did you see that I said movie Friday?
I did.
Okay.
But right when you said that, Ryan threw something else in the chat.
Yeah.
And then no one said anything.
Well, I saw Mike reacted to it though, so.
With like a thumbs up or something?
Yeah.
Thumb sideways?
With a heart.
A thumbs doing a backflip?
Yes.
And we see this thing. And because we got trapped at the windmill, we know that that blue box equals place on a time.
Okay, if I were to play this and I could not remember all the songs, is that an option like in the start menu to like...
Yes, if you go to the start menu and we go over here, there's a song list here.
Okay, cool.
Not only does it will it show you... but if you click into it, it will play it, and then you could practice the song.
Right. Okay.
With it too, so it they do remind you like there is a section for it.
Good.
And they even let you practice it. So yes, then they thought of that. They don't just make you remember everything. That'd be kind of fucked.
That is a cool feature. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, because like. Well, that's why I asked. Like, if it was me playing, like, I couldn't remember all those.
Right. I remember. Because, one, I actually have a decent memory. But, two, I've been playing this game for 20 years.
Right.
20 plus. This is a like. Don't let it suck you up. Because he will steal your items.
Shit.
And not just, like, something simple. Like, he will take the tunic off your back. And I just realized that I didn't have to be in here. I always forget what's in this room. I just know that it's not required. It's a gold spatula. Yeah, Chris, yeah. Trustin says the same thing. I won't remember. I take pride in the brain of memory things. Stuff.
Oh. Yeah. I really didn't... Oh, I see. Okay.
So the fire down below, it doesn't kill you immediately, but if you stand in it, it will damage you over time. You are if you're wearing the Goron tunic, you are resistant to it.
Right.
So it takes longer for you to get damaged, but it will damage you if you stay in it. I'm gonna blow that up.
Kaboom!
You just never bloody nerd.
Speaking of losing items, do you remember the time yesterday when I lost all my magic items? That was cool.
Yes. But then we did gamble and bargain for
one of my things.
One of your things, and then you got another thing. So, like, we are given, like, with these campaigns, which I'm going to try very hard not to do because it's just so much for no reason. We are given so many magic items. It's kind of ridiculous because we keep on getting introduced to these things that, like, shops or characters that will give us these big items.
Well, if it ever gets around to my turn, I'm not giving you guys a bunch of anything, because I can't keep track of it.
Well, it'd be our job to keep track of it.
True.
If we don't keep track of it, then, well, we're not using it. It's just that everybody's decently good at remembering that shit. The main thing you have to worry about is your world, like, your story, your world, and, like, your NPCs, you know? Like, all that shit.
Well, and then your guys' stories, like...
Yes. And so our stories would also be part of that.
Yeah.
Depending on, like, the kind of game you want to run, like the Supernatural one, like, our backstories won't be too big into it, you know?
Well, I mean, yeah, like we've said before, with that, it's just going to be
your
what got you into hunting.
Right, yeah, and then we just do the huntings. We can make it bigger. By the way, that puzzle, a big fire stack... Like, that goes up in the air, you push the block, and the block is now a platform that brings you up here.
Yeah, I was watching it.
Okay.
I
want you to soak in the puzzles while I'm just
kind
of blasting through them. Magma slugs.
Yeah, there's only one that you, like, kind of let me say stuff about. All the other ones, you're just like, and we're done.
Nope, go forward. But yeah, so you don't have to keep track of other people's items. But, like, so one of the reasons why some parts of the campaigns, like, are so slow is because, like, every chance we get, like, there's always, like, a shopping episode, and we spend so much time just trying to get items, and there's, like, so many opportunities to get items that it's... For me, I start, like... Be like, okay, are we done yet? Like, can we, like, move on to the next thing? Like,
I kind of feel like with the current campaign, I feel like we've just done a lot of shopping. Like,
it's been a lot.
Yeah.
By the way, so there's a thing there, a crystal that deactivates the fire.
Mm-hmm.
I use a bomb to try to get me a little bit of a head start because there is a timer.
Okay.
See, like, it's already over. Like,
oh.
That's how much time you have. You know?
So the bomb didn't...
No, the bomb blew it up. I had a little bit of a head start.
Right, okay.
I ran into a fucking boulder. But yes, like recently, we've definitely been doing a lot of shopping.
Yeah.
Because Joey, like, introduces these big cities, and...
Well, yeah, so, I mean, you want to check all the stuff out.
Yeah, but then it just becomes, like, half the session is just that. So, like, for me...
Always do that to me.
What, just be awesome?
Yeah.
And you,
sorry,
and,
I interrupted
and,
you.
And you freak out because you're like, oh, you can't do that, and then I'm like, I'm awesome. And you're like, oh, fuck.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. But yeah, so, like, you want to check out all the stuff, so.
Yeah. But it just gets to the point where, like, again, like, half the session, if not more, is, like, just going around town and stuff. Which, like, I get, you know, wanting to check out whatever town you're in and, like, see what's in there. But, like, eventually I want to...
Go do stuff?
I want to progress the story.
Yeah.
You know? I'm just getting fucking bad. It's only, like, a quarter heart every time, so, like, I don't care. I just kind of blast through this because I'm doing this little maze, which, yeah, funny, like, the camera, you can see out of bounds and where the gate goes.
Yeah.
Just, like, it's right there.
Right. And you
just get to see out of bounds. Look at that. Anyway, hi. I don't care about you. Ah, damn it. Because you can't fucking skip these either, so it takes so much time. Doors that fall down when you try to open them. If you use a sample of the Goron's special crop, you can break it. Sick. Oh. He's talking about using bombs. I know how to use bombs. Thank you. Okay.
Not like we haven't been using them.
But yeah, so there's been a little bit too much of shopping episodes as of late. And I'm just like
they are aggressively killing each other over there.
That's why, like, for the pirate campaign, like, I'm not gonna try to have too many of those types of shops. Honestly, like, when it really comes down to it, the only person who's gonna have anything, like, worthwhile when it comes to actual shops of, like, good magic items is gonna be that old lady.
Right.
That you guys run into. Otherwise, no. Like, there's gonna be shops, but it's not gonna be, no. Like, every shop is gonna be giving you amazing magic items and be constantly rolling on tables and stuff. Like,
yeah,
it's I also like it better when you find, like, the good shit out
through dungeon crawling.
Yeah, through dungeon crawling or through, like, story beats, you know?
Right.
Like, that's a lot more interesting to me than, you know, getting our entire attunement slots filled up just because we
went shopping.
We shopped around, you know?
Yeah.
So, there's an eyeball on the wall.
Uh-huh.
So, really the only way you can find that out is if you look around. You're like, well, this seems like a tall room. Oh, shit, there's an eyeball. I realized that we could hit eyeballs from the very first dungeon. So I'm going to use this bow I have from the last dungeon to hit the eyeball from this dungeon. This gives me, I'm pretty sure, dungeon map. Is that or a compass? It's one of the two.
I keep hitting stuff.
It's dungeon map.
I'm trying to stretch, but I keep hitting stuff.
Well, figure it out. So we got a dungeon map, so didn't really actually need to go in that room. Also, this drops you down all the way to the first room.
Oh, my.
Yeah. Well, not, like, the first room, but, like, the first room after meeting Darunia.
The first room after the first room?
Yeah. The first real room. And then we go over here, and we're about to get chased by some fire. Hi, fire.
Nice.
Bye, fire. Jumps.
See?
It just... every little thing. Jump. Now we're up here.
I have no perception. So, like, everything just seems... well, I guess not everything, but... a lot of the times, it feels like stuff is, like, just too far away.
Yeah, just too far away. I also, like, really know the distances, and sometimes I do, like, really cut it close sometimes.
Yeah.
There's are times where I'm like, I definitely got this, and you're like, oh my god!
Well, that's like, I mean, we've talked about it before, too, but... That was one of my biggest things with Little Nightmares was I was so thrown off at certain points of, like, having to jump around.
Yes.
I was so...
well, I don't like that game when it comes to platforming because of how the camera is, because that game does have a true depth perception problem. because of the camera, but the game is so dark that there's not a lot of things that could tell you like where you are in relation to other things a lot, like how games do a lot of times use like shadows and other things, or
right,
just understanding like, that certain like certain distances are gonna be good enough for the character just instinctually. Like I know Link can make that jump because I know like one, that's the only way to get over there. And then I could just, like, Link has one jump.
Okay, so tell me, how many blocks can he jump? And then you're going to do it.
How many, well...
Like, from, you know, from here, like...
The thing is, there's no jump button in 3D Zelda games. Outside of, like... Okay. So the only way you can jump off of things...
Okay.
Is if you go off a ledge. Then he will automatically jump if you go off a ledge.
Okay. Got it.
So there's no jump button. The only 3D Zelda game that has a jump button is Breath of the Wild and Tears of the Kingdom. Otherwise, yeah. But I did want to show, like, so going from the top room leads you to back to this room. If you press the button from this side, it does bring you back to this room. Mm-hmm. The room that had the crystal that let me go up.
Right.
Did I say you could speak?
Aww.
Shut it.
The baby.
Baby could be fucking quiet. And now, because I got the key, I have to climb back here. There's a magma slug. By the way, so we went through the one room before. Now, if you recognize, we are on the top of the walls that were in the maze that we were in before. So, does that feel
mm-hmm.
recognizable to you? Okay, cool. What? Hit the button. Open the thing over there.
Tristan's computer must have broke.
Or he's just kind of hanging out. What? And then we're gonna jump. Also, doing a roll jump kind of gives you a little more distance. Whoop. You're saved. GG. Bye. Yep.
Oh, no. Lava.
Bye, lava. Slug. Got the easy route. Because I don't want to balance on small walls if I don't have to. Bye. Hit. And then back to this room. Haha. Then we're about to get chased by fire again. Because that always happens in this room. But instead of going to the other end, we go up here. Whee! Because this is the locked door that we couldn't access before. But now we have a couple keys because we ran through. Now we can access this. This brings us to the next area. Tyler blew it up. And now we have another fire maze that I always have trouble with. Because if you walk up to certain walls, fire appears.
Nice.
So you kind of have to feel it out. Fuck off. Thank you. You didn't even give me anything. If you're gonna die, give me an item. Give me a heart.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it kind of happens like right when you're next to it. So you have to walk pretty carefully.
Right.
And then here, I'm gonna go against the wall because that happens.
Nice.
Oh.
Oh my god.
And then... Okay.
Nice.
And then we go through here. What's up, Goron? Bye, Goron. Can't really do anything with you right now. So then that leads us to this section. So you couldn't get to this side. So we're in the same room now that we were in before.
Mm-hmm.
But we're this entire wall is fire. So you have to go through the maze over there in order to come out this side to be on this side. Now, if I want to try... Fuck me. Oh, I didn't actually get hurt that time, oddly enough. I need to remember the maze here, so... It's this way... Okay. Button. Lack of fire.
Yay!
There's a time limit. Alright. I need bombs. Thank you for giving me bombs. More bombs. Thank you.
Sweet.
Because there's gonna be a fake door.
What?
I forgot about the fake door. I knew there was fake doors in this dungeon. I forgot it was there. But the fake door, you blow it up and it actually blows up the wall behind it. And now we're in the mini boss. What
Sweet.
Up? Bitch. Throw a bomb at it. While it does that. And then it tries to run. You hit it a few times. And then it does that. And then rinse and repeat. I just try to hit it in a way where it won't even run. I don't even give it a chance to run. Because then it gets annoying. That's gonna blow. Alright, it's fine. And then that's the mini boss.
Nice. That was quick.
Yeah.
And I mean, mini,
boop,
so.
Boop. I'm gonna do a backflip. Sick.
Dork.
Aha! Oh, yeah. Since we're in a hot place, his eye animation. Do it again. Okay, I'm not gonna wait any longer. There's the so sometimes depending on where you're at, his eye animation changes.
Uh-huh.
There is one like when you're in a high area where he will like swipe off sweat off of him.
Uh-huh.
And then if he's in the cold area, he will actually like shiver and shit.
Nice.
So Crystal, and then you see that you can't get over here, but before you realize, oh, crystals could turn off fire. I'm going to use a bomb, so then I'm going to drop the bomb there, because again, time limit.
Right.
Aha.
Yay.
And now we're up here. And now we're in this room. Now, there's a switch. Up the stairs, there is a chest. The chest has fire surrounding it. The cutscene will show you that. And you have a time limit. But you have to go on this in order to get there.
I hate it. I hate it.
And then we open it. Megaton Hammer. It's the legendary hammer they foreshadowed.
And break junk.
Yeah. So, we go to the pause menu. We go over here. And now we have a big hammer.
Yay. Big hammer.
The Megaton Hammer. It's the legendary hammer that defeated the fire dragon years ago by the legendary Goron hero. Or whatever.
Or whatever.
Ow.
Wow. You just let him come right up to you.
Yeah, that's fine. You know what? Now he's dead.
Good.
So now we have access to much more of the dungeon. So in order to get out of this room, we're going to go here. See this little uprise platform.
Mm-hmm.
Hit it with a hammer. Whee.
Whee.
We're down here now. And we're like, well, now we're trapped. What do we do? Fuck this guy. We use our new hammer to make those go away. Sweet. Now there's a door.
Sweet.
and kill these things. And we're like, well, I hit the thing that looked like this before. Let's do it again. Fucking make stairs. And if we went down there, we would see that there was a blue switch.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we've accounted blue switches before. They don't stay down. But there are boxes here, conveniently.
Mm.
How convenient. Go away. Cool. So now, step on the switch. Door opens. We leave the box there. So then we can go through the door.
Yay.
And then fucking rinse and repeat. Hit the thing. Falls down. We fall down with it. We're here now. Now there's a third type of switch now. Rusted switches. Now he's about to say it. So rusted switch, you can't press on it with your weight alone. You have to hit it with a hammer in order for the switch to be pressed. Who the fuck do you think you are? Now before we go through that door, we're going to hit this. Because that platform leads to the room that we saw Darunia.
Mm-hmm.
So hitting that makes a platform so that we could actually get to the boss room. So you have to make sure you hit that first.
That's a lot of prep work.
Now, there's a blue block over there, and we know what to do about blue blocks. Everything's connected. The game has a way to to push you in the direction depending on what you have or haven't done. And that clearly gets more and more complicated the more, like, the later into the dungeons we go, because now we're in the adult dungeons, so clearly these dungeons are going to be taking longer, plus there's, story shit happens too. But, right. So, like, where we did all, like, started the game and did three areas before, nearing the end of the stream, we're still in the middle of the second one.
Right.
So, I mean, granted, again, the story shit happened, but now I have a key. Now I have to remember where to go from here. Oh, wait, that's right. We're gonna go back up here. Because now with the Megaton Hammer, and we broke this, so now we can go all the way down here. It's fine. So it's programmed to be fine, so I'm fine. So now we are back in the main room, but crazy, funky, crazy, crazy.
Yeah.
Well, there's a door there. But,
funky, crazy, crazy.
I don't want that door yet. The thing that we hit before. Give me a heart. No? Cunt. We hit these things, and we use the key that we just found to open this door.
Yay!
And then that brings us through this room. And just like the slugs from Link to the Past, if you use the big hammer you get, it flips them like a pancake.
Flip them.
Why are you still alive? So yeah, we're supposed to kill everything in the room in order to gain access to things and shits and stuff and whatnots. I don't need to deal with you, so I won't. Now we have Megaton Hammer. Now we can do the same thing the bomb does. Because Megaton Hammer will destroy things that bombs can also destroy. Mostly.
Mm-hmm.
So if we go up to him and then fuck it up and hit him with a hammer, it will do the same thing as the bombs did before. Well, how did you not get hit? There we go. And then one more phase. Pow, clash, poom, bow, de bam, badim, stu bam.
Badiggy dee.
Yeah. I did a backflip because I'm a cool guy. And then a chest! Grab the chest. It's a small chest. And some more bombs.
Oh my god.
Nope. See, now that we have the Megaton Hammer, the switches are rusted.
Right.
Fucking crazy convenient. And this Groron was just hanging around, you know, the second most important chest in the entire dungeon, the boss key. Alright, bye. You're saved or whatever. Have fun being a free Goron. Can't really call you a man. Because they don't have genders. They just are. Hut! Hit! Alright, here we go. Da-na-na-na. Oh shit, what's happening? Oh fuck. Hey! Shut up. What's happening? Oh no, our exit. Bye. Volvagia, the subterranean lava dragon.
Yikes.
Yes.
Big yike.
Yeah, look at that big guy. Boo doo 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 doo. So we gotta see where he comes up, grab your hammer, and then bust his face open. I'm gonna do a bunch of jump attacks if I can. I'm also gonna bring down my arrows real quick. But then you could like kind of shoot at him, you get a little more damage. And then I like to step back to see where he's gonna pop out of.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you pay attention to marks, he'll pop out. And then he comes back out again. Does that. Alright, he disappears because he's about to throw boulders at us. Just look for the shadow. Just like on Death Mountain, which I guess we're in Death Mountain, but whatever. What's up, ass face? Alright. Now, this time he's gonna fake us out.
That one on your left. Oh.
Aha!
I mean, I only had a, like, 1 in 8 chance or whatever, so.
Swiped at me. And there we go. Volvagia is Deadagia.
Nice.
And now, yeah, he's just bones. And his head turns into a heart container. We got more hearth. Backflip. And that guy's just kind of watching. Oh, fuck.
It's like confetti coming out of there.
Yeah. Yeah. Embers are just fire confetti. Is Darunia's a sage?
What?
Somebody else we know happens to be a sage? Fucking what?
What?
Thank you, brother. I really appreciate what you did. I thank you on behalf of the entire Goron race. All of them. You turned out to be a real man, just as I thought you would. By the way, I, the wild Darunia, turned out to be the great Sage of Fire. Isn't that funny, brother? Well, this must be what they call destiny. Nothing has made me happier than helping you seal the evil here.
Yay.
We did it. Hey, brother, take this. This is a medallion that contains the power of the fire spirits and my friendship.
Aww.
Yeah, friends and stuff.
Friends and stuff.
I mean, he fucking named his son after us, so I mean, shit.
Right.
Shit. We got the fire medallion. And shit. You received the fire medallion. You got two out of the fight. Don't forget, now you and I are true brothers. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And then we're back in Death, not the Crater. Now I need to double check something before we end. So we're gonna go back over here. Gonna do this. Blah. Now, can I destroy these silver rocks with a Megaton Hammer, or are they Silver Gauntlets exclusive? They're Silver Gauntlets exclusive. But I know I can make this jump, because it's lower. Climb up the ladder. The ladder. The fuck you do. Alright, now after this, I want to say that could get us started on a side quest. But let's see if he's rubbing his eyes. No.
Brother.
Alright, I don't know what starts the side quest. But we're going to end it off there. So we got two out of the five stages. We started our adventure being Adult Link and shit.
Yeah.
Also, thing I was about to mention, but because we are not going to be playing Skyward Sword, but Skyward Sword is actually decently important into talking about the timeline. We'll get into the like nitty gritty when at the end of this game when I go over timeline shit. Mm-hmm. Up to this point at least. But one of the things that Skyward Sword does is talk about the creation of the Master Sword. So Link does go through a process that. Has him go from the Skyward Sword, like that's literally the name of the sword, is the Skyward Sword.
Right.
Into making it into the legendary Master Sword that we see today. So we do see not only the origin of Hyrule and like the curse, but also the Master Sword itself. So a lot of origin shit happening in Skyward Sword. In Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, made in 2011 for the Nintendo Wii. And then remade for the Switch. Your companion Fi, is in the sword. She is the embodiment of the sword.
Oh.
So whenever we play any Zelda game, just know that she is always in the sword. Now, clearly that's a retroactive thing.
Yeah.
But now just comfortably know that there's technically an entity inside the sword.
Right.
But that's going to be it for this stream. I'd like to thank everybody for showing up to the stream. Very much appreciate all of you. I just realized I forgot to open the bot, but it's fine. I also like to thank all the names going to be popping up to the left. And I'd like to thank CyberCore for being the stream team and a party. If you want to continue discussion, get announcements about future streams, events, talk about various different subjects, and more, go to the Pothead's Discord. You can also follow me at the social medias at PlayPod Co. and my YouTube at PlayPod. Links to those and more are down below. And until next time. Bye.
Thank you.